Hey y'all, it's Jen, and today I am doing the I Dare You book tag. Now, I was tagged to do this video by Amber of Amber's Books and More, and I don't know who the original creator of this tag is. I have searched and searched and searched, and I have not been able to find it. I do think that it possibly started in the blogger world, not on BookTube, but I haven't been able to find an original link yet. So if anybody knows who originally started this tag, please be sure to let me know in the comments below, and I will link them in the description box. So anyway, let's get started. There are 19 questions to this, and there are three rules. Rule number one is you must be honest. Rule number two, you must answer all of the questions. And rule number three, you must tag at least four people. Number one, what book has been on your shelves the longest? This is a toss-up for me. I can't exactly remember, but these are the two books that have been on my shelves the longest, to my knowledge. Most of my books, after I read them, unless they're my absolute favorites, I give them to somebody else to enjoy and read. I don't hold on to books anymore because I've moved a lot over the years and books are heavy. So if they didn't have significant meaning to me, I haven't kept them. And even some that have had significant meaning over the years, I've gotten rid of. So, it's either Grimm's Complete Fairy Tales or this box set of Little House on the Prairie books. This box set was given to me by my grandparents. I think my grandfather specifically. I can't remember how long, but as you can see, these books are not in great shape. Honestly, I've never actually read them. I know that's awful, but it's never been a story that has interested me. But because of the sentimentality of it, having been given to me by my grandfather, I have kept them. At one point in my, between high school and college and getting married and having kids, my mother had these and stored them for me in her storage building. Apparently developed a leak, and there's a lot of water damage to these and to the box. And also, just because we live in Arkansas and it was in a metal storage building, the heat and humidity and change in temperatures alone was horrible for books. And so these are not in the best of shape anymore. Number two is, what is your current read, your last read, and your next read? Oh, I'm actually currently actively reading three books. I say actively because if you look at my Goodreads currently reading list, I think I've got five or six on there. But I am almost always reading a physical book, or a dead tree book, as I like to call them sometimes, a Kindle book, and I'm also always listening to an audiobook. So right now I am listening to The Mothers by Britt Bennett. My Kindle book that I'm currently reading is Test Drive by Riley Hart, and that is book three in the Crossroads series. And my current physical book is You're Welcome, Universe by Whitney Gardner. Now, the books that I just finished reading are book number two, Shifting Gears in the Crossroads series by Riley Hart. My audiobook that I just finished was Between Shades of Gray by Ruta Sepetys. Last physical book I read was The Indian in the Cupboard by Lynn Reed Banks. My next book that I plan on reading is the fourth book in the Crossroads series by Riley Hart. My next audiobook read, I'm not really sure what it's going to be. It depends on what's available from my library. But my next physical book read will be Stalking Jack the Ripper by Carrie Mansicalo. I can't pronounce her last name. And I've tried, and I've listened to her pronunciation of it, and I still can't get it. My mouth just doesn't form it correctly, I guess. So anyway, this will be my next read. I have been working on this since December. I am one chapter in to it, and I just got busy and I haven't picked it back up yet. So this will be my next read. I'm on spring break. I've got 4 more days and I'm finishing this book. Number 3, what book did everyone like but you hated? That would be The Goldfinch by Donna Tartt. I hated that book. Number 4, what book do you keep telling yourself that you're going to read but you probably won't? You know, I don't know. I don't have one for this because normally if I say I'm going to read it, then eventually I do get to it. I don't know. Number 5, what book are you saving for retirement? So I didn't think I had an answer for this question, but it turns out that I do. Because normally I read as books come out. I don't hold off on books. If it's something I want to read, I grab it and I read it. I don't think, oh, well, I'll read this when I get time or I'll read this later or whatever. But When Pride Still Mattered, A Life of Vince Lombardi by David Marinus. I think I'm going to have to save this for retirement. I am very interested in the story of Vince Lombardi. I think he is an amazing man from what I know about him, and so I really, really wanted to read this biography. It's dense. It's got a lot of dense stuff in it, so it's just going to take a lot of time when I'm just going to be able to sit down and dedicate the time to this and the attention span that it requires, which probably won't happen until I retire. So, number 6, last page, read it first or wait until the end. I would not ever read that first. I don't understand how people do that. Why? Definitely wait till the end. There's a progression to the story and I want to see how we get to that point at the end, and I don't like spoilers. I don't want spoilers. Sometimes it happens and I don't really get all bent out of shape about them for the most part, but I don't intentionally want to spoil it. I don't want to know what happens. I don't want to start at the end and work my way forward. So yeah, definitely first page, last page at the end. Number 7 is the acknowledgments. Waste of paper and ink or interesting aside? And I have mixed opinions on this. I don't typically read the acknowledgments. There are a few that I will always read. Libba Bray's acknowledgments are hysterical. I love her acknowledgments. But most of the time, unless they are interesting or catch my attention, I don't usually read them. Every now and then I'll skim through them, but most of the time I get to the last page of the book and I'm done. I don't go past the last page of the story. Number 8, which book character would you trade places with? This is a tough one. I don't know that there's any of them that I would want to trade places with. Maybe America Singer in the Selection series. I wouldn't mind being a princess. But most of the books I read are either sci-fi or dystopian or true crime, mystery, you know, those kinds of books. And none of those are worlds that I would really like to be in. So maybe America Singer from The Selection. That, she sounds like a good one. Number 9, do you have a book that reminds you of something specific in your life? Either a time, a person, or a place. And yes, I actually have 2 answers for this question. There is a book called The Myth of You and Me by Leah Stewart. And it is about the ending of friendships and how that relationship, when it ends, especially if it ends without any specific closure, and you just don't know why it ends or what happened, where the disconnect went or what you did, it can be devastating and it can carry through your life. And at the time that I read this book, I had actually just experienced that kind of loss, the loss of my best friend. And this book helped me realize through reading it that our friendship probably wasn't the best. We weren't really good for each other as friends. So the ending of our friendship was probably a blessing in disguise. That book in particular helped me bring closure to that friendship. The other book or series that reminds me of something specific is the Harry Potter series by J.K. Rowling. I started reading these books to my children when my oldest daughter was just 5 years old. She turned 6 in the middle of reading this book, but when the movie came out for the first book, she was very interested in seeing it. Even at 5 years old, she was very aware, very mature for her age. And so I read it to her and to my youngest daughter at the same time. I wanted to really make sure that they had a love for books and that they read a book before they saw the movie. And I wanted to instill in them that how important that was and how different the two are. And I used that as an opportunity to bond with them over a book and instill my love of reading in them and also teach them that lesson. So we did end up reading the first Harry Potter book together when, you know, my oldest daughter was 5, 6 years old, and my youngest daughter was only 3 or 4 at the time. So she didn't really retain a lot, but it was just that bonding moment where we were reading a book, a chapter a day before bedtime, and kind of just that ending the day bonding tradition moment that we had that was real important to us at the time. And then I took him to see the movie. We read the first book together and the second book together in that manner, a chapter a night at bedtime. And then by the time the third book came out and we were ready for it, it was to the point that my oldest daughter was old enough and big enough, mature enough, and at the reading level that she could read the book herself. So at that point, we each read the book. I read the book first and then passed it on to her. Obviously, I'm a quicker reader than a 9, 10, 11-year-old would have been. So, but that's how we continued the series throughout. We always talked about it. We always saw the movies. And when the third book came out, they were old enough that I took them to the midnight viewings of those. So we got to experience that together as well and that atmosphere. This is a tradition that my oldest daughter and I have continued on for several of the book series that we have read together that have become movies. We have watched all of the Harry Potter movies together in the theater, including the most recent one that came out with Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them. She is now 20 years old, about to turn 21. So this has been a lifelong tradition for us. But we also saw all the Twilight movies and we saw all the Divergent movies together. I was really disappointed and upset and heartbroken almost that when the final Divergent movie came out, that would be the end of it and we wouldn't have any more books together. We also Hunger Games as well. But J.K. Rowling has saved the day for me, and we've got at least 5, now 4 more movies to watch together in that Harry Potter verse. So I'm real excited about that we get to carry on that tradition and that bonding experience for a few more years. Number 10, name a book you acquired in an interesting way. Most of my books, they are either given to me or I purchase them. But when I was 19 years old, 18, 19 years old, I worked at Olive Garden as a hostess, and somebody left a book on the ledge by the hostess stand. That book was Schindler's List, and I picked it up. It was a boring night. Nobody was coming in. We didn't have a lot to do, so I picked it up and started reading it at that point. And I ended up reading the entire book, and I loved it. So that is the most interesting way I have picked it up. Kind of a book in the wild, and left at my job, and I picked it up and read it. Number 11, have you ever given a book away for a special reason to a special person? Yes, I have. Jinx by Margaret Wilde. One of my best friends in junior high was a story writer. She's now an English teacher. We are still in contact, even though she moved away from me. Our 9th grade, 10th grade year, she moved away, a few states away. But in her stories, she wrote about the kids she grew up with. And in her book, my character name was Jinx. And in this book, I saw it, the book title is Jinx. And the main character's name in this book, her official name or regular name, whatever you want to call it, is Jen. And this book is told in poems or short, I don't know what you would call them. They're really kind of poems on here. When I bought this, I bought 2 copies of it. I kept a copy to read, and I mailed her a copy for her to read. And so that has special meaning to both of us, because she still calls me Jinx to this day, and it's been 15, 20 years now. I don't know how that story ended that she wrote, but one day maybe she'll publish it. Number 12, which book has been with you the most places? Other than my books that have moved with me throughout the years, I don't know that there is one. My Kindle, I take it everywhere I go since I've had it, and I've had a Kindle now for 7-8 years, so that would be the one that would have gone the most places with me. Number 13, any required reading you hated in high school that wasn't so bad 2 years later? And that would be no. Anything that was required reading in high school, I either loved it or hated it at the time, and I still feel that way today. I did enjoy most of our readings that we did in high school, but not all of them. I wasn't a big fan of the epic stories like Beowulf or the Canterbury Tales, and I still wouldn't be real huge fans of those at this time. Number 14, used or brand new? And I really don't have a preference as long as used is good condition. Number 15, have you ever read a Dan Brown book? Yes, I have read The Da Vinci Code and I've read Angels and Demons. I did like both of them, but my reading tastes have changed a lot since those books came out, and I probably would not pick up another one of his at this time in my life. Number 16, have you ever seen a movie you liked more than the book? Yes, and I actually have 2 answers for this. I was not a fan of New Moon in the book form of the second book in the Twilight series, but I thought they did a really amazing job on the movie for it, so I really liked it better than the book. The other one would be Under the Tuscan Sun. I thought the movie was fantastic. It was very romantic. It was fabulous. It's set in the Italian countryside, and it was just amazing, and I thought I need to read this book because I just loved the movie so much. And then the book was awful. It was the first book that I remember DNFing. I could not get past it. It was horrible. It was nothing like the movie. It was whiny and bitter, and I don't even know how they got the movie from that book, from the parts that I read, so. Under the Tuscan Sun, definitely movie is better than the book. Number 17, have you ever read a book that's made you hungry, cookbooks included. Yes. There is a couple of what I like to call cozy chick-lit mysteries that are centered around bakeries. There's two different series. The Joanne Fluke series is the one I'm currently reading on, and it's a cookie shop. She makes cookies, and I get hungry for her cookies every time I read one of her books. Number 18, who is a person whose book advice you'll always take? For me, the only person in my everyday life that I would take book advice for almost without questioning it would be my oldest daughter. We tend to like the same books and read the same type of books. And every book that she has said, "Mom, you have got to read this book," I have loved. Hunger Games, she actually read those books first and told me that I needed to read them. And so I did, and I loved them. She talked about them for months before I decided to pick up the first one. She's never steered me wrong. And so her advice I would always take, or her recommendations. Number 19, is there a book out of your comfort zone that you ended up loving? And for me, that would be the Game of Thrones of Fire and Ice series books. I do not typically like the high fantasy science fiction books. I don't typically like the blood and gore, the war stuff, but I have really loved the Song of Ice and Fire series. So far, I'm only on book 4. So that is all for the I Dare You book tag. I am not going to tag anybody, so consider yourself tagged if you are watching this video. I don't know who's done this tag already, and I don't know a lot of people. I'm just really too new to the BookTube community. So again, if you are watching this, consider yourself tagged. Please do this book tag for me, and be sure to tag me in the comments, or link to your video in the comments so that I can watch it. If you have read any of these books, if you agree with me or disagree with me, please let me know in the comments below. I'd love to have a conversation with you about them. And as always, be sure to give me a thumbs up if you've liked this video, and subscribe if you want to see more content from me. Until next time, bye!